seeing how far behind Bang is at the moment. Looking for a little bit of a trade. Slingshot getting ready to come through. Score will be jumping in.
Interrupts!
Bang. Interrupted. Pops the shield, but it's not going to be enough. First blood does come through as it's handed over to Def. Now they're looking for Wolf. As the ultimate still available, as well as his flash. We'll go ahead and pop that charge his way out. But now KT going to be looking there for their first turret here. 15 and a half minutes in. Quite a bit of damage down onto it. Scores in the vicinity, looking for anybody to cut off. He's going to go ahead and jump in onto Peanut as the ultimate pulls him back. And for a little bit more, Hook connects in onto Wolf, not onto the Maokai. It looks like Peanut will be going down. A couple more hits, gets us that magic passive and the smite to try to keep him alive, but he'll go down in the end as Pawn finds the second kill of the game. Still 1,500 gold up. His KT finds the hook after the leap. Bang immediately has the flash away as well as pop the barrier. Now KT are primed to go ahead and knock down this outer turret in mid.
So they can draw out both and actually have their own Sheen auto attacker with Mountain Drake, Shen with Titanic Hydra push. That could be big. As finally, we see Faker and Pawn in that mid to late game.
He's looking for the play, but the Stand United is there, as you're just talking about. The Shen Faker tries to make it over to that Honeyfruit and set, jumps into the pit. Might have to use the flash, does so to get himself out safely. In the meantime, Peanut throwing down that Nature's Grasp will get jumped on. The Ren comes through, and Deft finds another kill. Two over to the Kalista, 3-0. KT Rolster are in full control. Score leaping in, looking for a pick, doesn't find much. Just take that Dark Passage out.
And Maokai can still turn fights. Teleports from Kassadin's and Gnar's can still turn fights. It's only in neutral areas like this where they can see this. Okay!
Oh, the hook is just gonna go ahead, land in on the Bang, regardless, and now the Ren comes down. Deft will keep himself alive. The explosive charge, not enough to find him, but they will find Faker. Another hook coming through. Ripwalk will not save you. It's a double kill to Deft. Four on the board for him, and KT might just be looking at Baron. If you're Bang, I don't even know who you hate more in that instance. Do you hate Score or do you hate Mata? The Deliverer or the Catcher? In the meantime, Faker getting jumped on. Shadow Dash comes through, and he is just going to mount Smeb. Will take that kill for himself, and Faker does not look very enthused in the booth. In the meantime, the rest of KT knocking down this inner turret in mid. Won't quite be able to take it, but they're getting top lane simultaneously. Seems like KT will be dissuaded for now. Very deep TP coming through from Faker. Down by the enemy Raptors, will be charging in through the mid lane looking for a play, but he spotted out, and that just might be the burn of the
TP. The minions are so important there to give them exact timing on where to go so Mata didn't just run
meantime,
into Faker.
Faker, maybe in a bad spot, has to use the flash. Will be jumping away.
Pawn Meanwhile,
back into the mid lane as they look for Antara, snatches him up, kidnaps him yet again, and delivers another kill unto Deft. Fifth for him, 5-0 on this Kalista, and that's going to be the inhibitor going over to KT.
I mean, SKT have such a slippery draft, but it's a pick come from KT because of their amazing mechanics in this game. They have penalized them to the maximum with Thresh and Zach that can go oh so wrong if those skill shots miss. They've already broken the base super early in the game, and all SKT can do is watch on in horror.
Another hook coming through, looking for Faker, flays him back, but he jumps over the Ripwalk. In the meantime, Wolf going low, Chain's coming through, not gonna have the lockup.
Three man!
Finds a massive Shadow Dash. Nature's Grasp thrown down by Peanut, but he is just likely to die yet again. Flashes away, gets locked down, another Ren over from Depp, puts another kill on the board, a second inhibitor going down. And honestly, KT are going to be looking to close out this game pre-35 minutes.
Everyone's predictions of 3-0 SKT. They always have the win over SKT. KT are trying to rewrite that and at least pick up game one. This is probably the time for SKT where you have to make the panic engage, where you have to make the last stand. The Alamo's not going to be the last inhibitor turret. This could just be three inhibitors down for SK Telecom.
Can't quite walk. Deft up comfortably to get in on top of it. Antara in that Meganar form at the moment is still threatening. Score's going to go in deep, however. Looks for the kidnap. Does find one in onto Wolf. Drags him away as he goes low. Shadow Dash comes through, and he is going to get taken down. Did not have the Unbreakable Will, and now Peanut will be suffering a similar fate. Another Ren might just do it. No, one more auto attack will take him down. Another double kill over to Deft, who seems like he is just having the perfect game, but it's the supporting cast around him that is really enabling it. Mata has been an absolute monster on this Thresh so far. Looking for the killing blow here. Pawn going low, takes quite a bit of damage, but Stand United will keep him healthy, and in the fight, dashes to the side for the pick in onto Antara. Comes up with a knockback. He'll get the pop onto the Zac, but he hasn't gone down yet. Neither has Depp, but Faker finally comes up with the kill, the massive shutdown, but he just delivers himself to death as well. Finally, a kill on the board for SK Telecom, but it might be the only one that they see.
Might extend the game, though, Achilios. Pawn has to teleport back in if they want to try to finish now. They don't have to be greedy. They're going to go for it anyway. This is definitely the KT way.
Looking for the turnaround. Hook going to go wide for once as Pawn comes in, gets popped up immediately, and Bang has quite a lot of damage to offer up onto that LeBlanc. He has to dash back, keep himself alive, but in the meantime, Lintara has fallen. Nexus is exposed. KT will go ahead, hold off for now, but they can just go ahead, scoop up another Baron, another Dragon if they really want it. Already getting started up. That's just going to have a massive amount of Ren stacks into that one. As Pawn finds Bang, takes him low, dashes in, one final chain will take him down, but can he get out alive? Headbutt Pulverize coming through, dashes over the wall. Baron has gone down. Dark Passage is there for Mata to go ahead and scoop up the LeBlanc, so he stays alive. And seems like it might just be three waves of Super Creeps very shortly here as the inhibitors might just go down again.
We outlined Bang's increased level performance, particularly in the Samsung series, with our pre-match graphic from OGN. This game has not been that. He's taken the ultra defensive route of going for barrier, having heal on his AD carry, but being caught too many times, been off on his rocket jumps too many times. He's dead as KT rolls to wither up with those Baron buff minions. Want to end the game.
Looking for its score. Going to be overshooting that one as Zhentarr desperately tries to build up the range bar. Needs one hell of a setup to try to turn this around for his team, but he is getting locked down and junked out. Lance the Sun in on the Pawn, pushes Score back towards the fountain, but can't get much more than that. In the meantime, Score has the kidnap onto two members as he drags Peanut and Wolf into the fight, but that's just going to be the Nexus going down as KT Rolster very decisively turned things on 15 minutes forward. They take down SKT in game one.